is a former Satanist, because there is a lot about Satanism the public doesn't know, and you can really expose, you know, what Halloween and what these, you know, different satanic practices are about and what the intention is behind them. So I wanted you to unpack a little bit more. Why is October Witchcraft Month for Satanists?
When I was in the satanic world, we had to take things into cycles. You call it seasons. In Jesus Christ, we call it seasons. We call it the demonic realm. We call it cycles. So every cycle has a demonic activity going on. October is three quarters of the cycle to finish the year strong in December as a satanic devil worshiper. So my job was to finish the year. October was a month to, unleash hell on people, the witchcraft practices, rituals, ceremony, and cleansings to get stronger in the demonic spirit, the demonic realm, so I can finish my year strong. Mm-hmm. And that's why October is so pivotal. Even Anton LaVey, which he was the high priest that created the Church of Satan in California in the 60s, he ran all the way till he died. He said one quote. He said, "I want to thank every Christian parent that allow their children to celebrate the devil one time a year."
That is so powerful. And so I think for viewers at home, they probably don't know that in Satanism, you have what you would consider high holidays, just like there's high holidays in the Bible. Is that correct?
Correct. I mean, we do copycats of what the Christian world does, what the church does. Even when I came as a young believer, I was disappointed with God, because I was like, well, everything they did, we did in the satanic church. They lay hands, we lay demonic hands. They spoke in tongues, we spoke in demonic tongues. Mm. They fell backwards in the spirit, we fell backwards in the demonic. So what is the difference between our church and their church? And God said, it's the presence of mind in the church that makes a whole difference between the satanic world and my presence in my church.
And that's also because the devil he's not a creator. All he can do is take something that is God's and pervert it. Isn't that right?
Copycat.
Mm-hmm.
And the key of the enemy is keeping you away from a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. You know, that is the main goal, to keep you away from God's best, to keep you away from your purpose, your destiny, your time on the earth, that you should be glorifying God. All I want you to do is just glorify my son, Jesus Christ, with the time I give you on the earth. And we let the devil come in and pervert our time, steal our time, steal our moment, steal our opportunity with God, because we celebrate things that ungodly, undespicable, and abomination in the eyes of God.
So for the people who are watching, what do Satanists do to celebrate Halloween?
So Halloween is like Good Friday, right? To us, right? Mm-hmm. Halloween to the devil will be like Good Friday. And then November 1st, which is the Day of the Dead, will be like Resurrection Sunday to us. To us, when I was in the demonic sign, when you were doing Resurrection Sunday, I do November 1st, the Day of the Dead. Resurrection means life. The Day of the Dead means death. Halloween means to us, you know, changing people's identity in the spirit realm, so we can entrap them, and then all hell will break loose in their life and in their marriage and their children, because there's a ripple effect in the demonic side to create that atmosphere, the demonic atmosphere in someone's life when you celebrate Halloween. So when we celebrate Halloween, it's like you celebrating Good Friday.
What would you say to parents?
Y el hermano Ramírez concluye pues que la celebración del Halloween tiene como objetivo capturar las almas de los que se disfrazan en esta época. Gracias por escucharnos a este pequeño extracto sobre los peligros del Halloween. Que el Señor Jesucristo esté con ustedes. Amén.